Okay, so guess what, people? We still haven't launched Seahorse. It's been blowing old boots all week. We've had 40 knot winds or so, and although I'm sitting here on Sunday and it's calming down to maybe 15, 20 knots, it's Sunday. The bosun's got better things to do, and we've actually got to go and get some guinea pigs. Yeah, I know. Don't ask. Anyway, the film about Hanks had such a good reception with so many great comments, I thought I'd introduce another topic of conversation. How to keep your mainsail under control. Now, the way I see it, you've got three options. You can have nothing, as in the sail just goes up and down the mast and you gather it up manually yourself and place it on the boom and put a cover on it when you're finished. You can have lazy jacks, which are the lines that go up to the mast and that contain the sail around the boom so that it keeps it under control as it's coming up and coming down. And then you can take that one step further and have a stack pack. So you have your lazy jacks effectively tied onto a sail cover that's permanently fixed to your boom, so that when you want to go sailing, you just have to unzip it, hoist your sail, and when you drop it, it falls straight in the bag and you zip it back up. So let's work through those options. The nothing option, which is our preferred option, all other things being equal. The real advantage of it is there's nothing to go wrong. There's nothing to get caught up. There's nothing to snag. There's nothing to break. There's nothing to depend on that might someday come untied or something. It's just foolproof. The disadvantages of it are that really you need the sail to stay permanently attached to the mast. So if you've got sliders that go up and down the track and don't come out of the track, it's great. If, like we had with Rowena, our little 20-foot trailer sailor, a bolt rope that effectively slid out of the mast when you dropped the sail, although the sail on that boat was tiny compared to what we used to, it was a real pain. And actually, it was better to have lazy jacks, but we'll come on to that. So as long as your sail stays permanently attached to the mast, the only real disadvantage with having nothing is that it can be awkward, especially on a windy day with sail blowing all over the deck. So there kind of comes a size of boat where finding an alternative can be preferable. I'd suggest maybe around 32 foot on a modern boat where you have a big main and a small jib, perhaps up to sort of 35, 36 foot on an older boat with a masthead rig where you have a small main and a big jib. Another topic of conversation for some point. But the size that you're comfortable with will vary between the people and the boats. Things like having fully battened mainsails make all this a little bit easier as well, because it's easier to hold the sail on the boom as you tidy up. So anyway, let's move on to lazy jacks then. The advantages are, obviously, the lines keep the sail under control. It is important to remember that the primary purpose of a lazy jack isn't to control the sail, really. It's just to keep it tidy. But the two kind of go hand in hand. So they hold the sail on the boom as you hoist it, you go sailing, and when you want to come and drop, you drop the sail, and the lazy jacks basically keep the sail on the boom. So it's easy enough to pull it along, tidy it up, and put your sail cover back on. The disadvantages are, well, the biggest disadvantage is snagging. We'll come on to that in a minute, and the ways you can deal with it. But the other disadvantage, certainly to me, as a part-time racing sailor, is they just shout cruiser. They look kind of rubbish to a sailor because they're spoiling the airflow over the sail, albeit minimally. But to me, the biggest problem is that they often rely on keeping the boat close to the wind. It is worth remembering that it's the boom that's important really, not the boat, but often you do need to go into the wind to hoist and drop your sail. And that means you need to use your engine. And that's not safe or cool really, is it? Although most of us do use the engine, if your engine fails, you don't want to not be able to hoist your sail. But there are ways of dealing with this. But before we do that, let's quickly take a look at stack packs. The advantage is obviously convenience and the time it saves in having to unroll your sail cover and roll it back up again. To me, that's not a big deal. I can see why it's appealing to the part-time cruiser. The disadvantages are the same as lazy jacks, snagging and all the things that go with it. Plus, you've now got a sail cover effectively permanently attached to the boom that will flap around and irritate someone like me. And the biggest problem is you can't do a lot of the things I'm going to talk about in a minute to alleviate the problems associated with these systems. So to me, stack packs are non-starter, but I'm sure you people that like them will let me know in the comments why they're great. Anyway, let's get back to the whole lazy jack stroke stack pack and talk about the ways in which you can make it useful. Because as much as I'd rather not have one, I'm not adverse to putting them on. Muskrat Ramble, our Beneteau 32, had lazy jacks, and I was quite happy with them. And White Magic, our Sunfast 32, didn't have lazy jacks, but as it turned out, the boom was quite high, and we just found it easier to fit lazy jacks to keep it under control. Although I made sure they were adjustable and I could get them out of the way when I wanted to. So let's get on to the things you can do. Firstly, your lazy jacks don't want to be more than about 75% of the way along the boom. Although it's tempting to put a line right to the end of the boom to keep that part of the sail under control, that's the bit that's most likely to snag. So really, don't put them any more than 75%. You could be less than that along the boom, and although the last little bit of sail at the end of the boom will fall off, there isn't much sail at that end, so it's not such a big deal. So the next thing is when you're hoisting and dropping, it's the boom you need to keep into wind. So uncleat your main sheet and move the boom, or at least let the boom move, to where it needs to go to weathercock into the wind. You'll find it much easier then to get the sail up and down. Although you'll still find you can't go too far off head to wind, because as the wind blows more and more to the side, the lines for the lazy jack system essentially get closer together. So the gap you've got to thread the sail up to get it up and down gets smaller. So you really want to keep as close to head to wind as you can. Next thing is, play with the tension on the loops of your lazy jack system. You'll always find it's one batten that gives you most problems. And having the lines tighter or looser can often alleviate that. Actually, that brings me on to another point. Any lazy jack system needs to be adjustable. And not only adjustable, you want to put some marks on the lines so that you know how much tension you've got on each side. Makes the whole dealing with the problems much easier. And the next thing to note is that lazy jacks work much better on free running sails. It's the snagging that's the problem. So the quicker you can get your sail up and the quicker it comes down, the less chance you'll have of having problems. If you have to winch it up slowly, I guarantee you'll be faffing around trying to unhook lazy jacks at some point or other. So the final bit of advice really, and it's something I never really thought of until I started to make this film, is that really, you only want the lazy jacks for the drop. I think if I had lazy jacks again, I would leave them permanently hooked over the reefing horns and out of the way against the mast. So that when I want to go sailing, I take the sail cover off, the sail will fall off the boom, but that's not a big deal. I hoist the sail, I go sailing. There was nothing to get in the way of me hoisting the sail or cause any kind of problems. And then, just before I want to drop the sail, I'll move the lazy jacks back to their normal position, adjust it to my mark, drop the sail, put the sail cover on, and then move the lazy jacks back to the reefing horn again, out of the way, so that I'll never have this problem of trying to hoist a sail and snagging on them. I've not worked it like that before, but I can see how that would be a good idea. Anyway, I suspect I've missed out lots of things that I should have spoken about, in the same way I missed out lots of things on the Hanks film. Thanks everyone for pointing out the bits I'd missed. Noticeably the most important being the problems you can have with a furler when they go wrong at the wrong time. Go back and have a read of some of the comments if you want to know more. Anyway, on the subject of that, please leave some comments on what your thoughts are on how to control your mainsail. As you can tell, I'm not adverse to lazy jacks, but I'd rather not have anything because as a racer it looks better and there's nothing then to go wrong. And I'm not sure I'd ever really want a stack pack. But I guess, if you're one of these people that sails these big catamarans and the boom is on the second story, it could be an advantage to have the sail fall into a bag so it's under control, but not my sort of sailing. Anyway, let me know people, what do you think of this? And what systems do you have? Meanwhile, we are going to go sailing one day, honestly. Here's to next week, let's hope the weather calms down.